Ginger, it's starting.
So it is.
Okay, that is not good.
What the hell is out there?
Bridget, what's happening?
Hey, sleepyhead. It's time.
All right. This is the first time I've covered a sequel on the channel, and what better sequel could I have gone with? Gingersnap 2 Unleashed is one of those really rare horror movie sequels that isn't just a carbon copy of what happened in the last film. It works as a decent continuation and continues the journey of Emily Perkins' character Bridget from where we left off. Considering that this is a review for a sequel, there will be minor spoilers. You have been warned. The events of the last film had us watch in horror as Bridget becomes infected with lycanthropy and is forced to kill her sister, the only person in her life that she was ever close with. She's off on her own now, trying to get by and managing by her affliction. Lycanthropy in this movie works like a disease where you only slowly turn into a wolf-like creature, and I believe the transformation is permanent. So no only full moon transformations or anything like that. At the end of the first film, Bridget discovers that she can use a plant called monk's hood to keep the affliction at bay, and the time between this film and the last one, she's been managing to keep her affliction in check, constantly using the monk's hood. However, it's become a bit habit-forming, and it's slowly losing its effectiveness. During the events of this film, Bridget has left her family behind and is now living on her own, trying her best to make it by. The events of the film kick into gear when she's attacked in a motel by another werewolf, a fully transformed werewolf. The police arrive and investigate when a few bodies hit the floor at the motel. They search Bridget's room, and that's when they discover the monk's hood. Not sure what it is, and thinking it's a drug, she's sent to a teen rehab clinic to get over her affliction. Even though monk's hood is not classified as a narcotic, she's being kept away from the miracle cure that's kept her alive all this time, and she needs to find a way to escape the rehab clinic before she fully transforms into the monster within. And that's not all. That werewolf that attacked her before? It may not want to kill her, but it definitely wants to mate with her. And it's not afraid to kill any human beings that get in the way. And it's out there,
waiting impatiently. Every day, it gets closer to breaking in and getting to Bridget.
Unlike the first film, where the theme was more of a coming-of-age story with some feminist power vibes to it, the sequel focuses more on the addiction and rehabilitation angle. Normally, you would expect a film from a film series to have one overarching theme, but in these movies, the overall theme of the story changes as the characters do. Bridget is practically an adult in this story, so it would be kind of weird to do another coming-of-age story on her. If they did go with the same theme again, they'd probably have to focus on a different character, and really, no matter who this character was, I really wouldn't want the sequel to take focus away from the main character from the last film, because she is what I'm interested in, and that's the main reason why anyone would want to watch this sequel. There are a ton of new side characters added to this story, and they are interesting in their own right. I will have to add that there's the character Alice, who runs the clinic and acts as an interesting foil for Bridget, who is intentionally doing her harm, but in the end, we all know she has good intentions. There's also a kid character named Ghost, who befriends Bridget in the story and is generally a strange and entertaining character overall. If I had to state any gripes with the film, the ending leaves a lot to be desired, as it unfortunately lives on a cliffhanger that begs for a continuation. There is a third film in the series, but for some reason they decided to make that a prequel that takes place in the 1800s, and that makes no sense to me at all. I would love to see a continuation to this, but I hold little hope that any such thing will ever happen. Personally, I enjoy this film a lot better than the first. I think Bridget is a lot more likable, and we get to learn a lot more about lycanthropy and the intricacies of it in the universe here. It's also got some really great werewolf effects and great tense scenes scattered out throughout the whole film. Minor spoiler, we never really find out who the other werewolf is in this film, and I'd like to think it's Tim from the first film who got infected from the virus after having sex with Ginger. I would almost say that that's a missed opportunity, we're not going for that route, but maybe leaving it ambiguous is a good thing. Unfortunately, since this is a direct sequel, this film does not stand on its own in any way, so I would only recommend this if you've seen the first. And if you really didn't like the first film, but are a general fan of werewolf films, you may like this one as it really decides to go for a different route. Overall, an enjoyable film, and I would recommend checking it out. If you're looking for it, you can find it for free on Tubi or Filmrise.